question was, what do you envision happening in the hobby in 10 years? How do you envision it? Well, you can sit back and dream, but 10 years? A safe answer is that we're going to see a whole lot more aquacultured fishes. How that technology will develop is the exciting part that we haven't seen yet. We got some hints, little bits. I think there's going to be a lot more. I think the word is extensive farming, where it's done in larger bodies of water instead of the small fiberglass tanks, ponds, more like for the freshwater hobby. It's already being done to some extent in Southeast Asia and a little bit in Mexico, with seahorses and a few actual species of angelfishes have been raised that way. So I believe that that's going to happen, probably in less than 10 years, but 10 years from now that should be commonplace. I think that there's going to be maybe some experimentation with hybridizing some of the fishes to achieve new varieties. Probably 50 to 60% of people in the hobby think that's a bad idea. And then the rest of them either don't know, or don't have an opinion, or think it's a good idea. I'm one of those who thinks it's probably a good idea, mainly because when you develop a new variety of something, it develops excitement in the hobby. And I think that excitement is a good thing. It brings new people in. It gets more people interested in trying aquaculture and breeding. Let's be realistic. It is a hobby. There is a certain amount of creativity to it, and I think we should not limit that creative potential. I don't like the idea of making weird things like googly-eyed fish, like what's done with the goldfish, or veil-tailed things. But developing interesting colors has some wonderful potential. I like what's been done with discus, for example. All the different strains of discus. We're seeing it already in the clownfish. Clownfish breeding has matured to a point where we're really developing some beautiful named varieties. And I think very few people would argue that that's a bad thing.